Well, good morning. I'm glad you guys all came. As I remember back when I was going to school here, didn't have much choice when they told you to go to assembly, you went to assembly. So thank you very much anyway for being here. I guess you didn't have much choice. But first of all, I'd like to congratulate the other graduates that are being honored here today. I know they feel like it's a special day in their lives like I do. It's not every day you get a chance to come back to your school after 40 years and receive this prestigious award. Thank you very much. You know, years ago when I was playing ball, and I used to go to a ball game in the spring when the weather was really bad, and I'd say to my teammates, every day is a great day to play ball, just some days are better than others. Well, what I meant was what every day is special, and today's an even more special day for me. It's a special day in my life, and I want to thank a lot of people for that. First of all, I'd like to thank the Distinguished Graduate Hall of Fame for inducting me into this Distinguished Graduate Hall of Fame. I really appreciate this award. I'd also like to thank the teachers who educated me here at Hopewell Valley High School. I wish I'd listened to them a little more. I think I'd have a little been better off, so I encourage you young people to do that. And I'd also like to thank the coaches that had helped me develop my talents so I can go on and reach my dreams of being a professional ball player. And of course, I'd like to thank my mother and father who encouraged and loved me. My father who pushed me along. He was always there for me, and so was my mother. And I'd like to thank my brothers and sisters. I have many of those. And they all helped me move along, and they fielded many ground balls and fly balls for me at the Washington Crossing Park when I was a youngster. And I wouldn't be standing here today if it wasn't for all those people. Well, what I've accomplished is in the past. That's history. You, the people in this room, are the ones that are going to be the future of our country. You're going to develop our country so you and your kids and grandkids can live the great lives we have all lived here in this great country we call America. My lifelong dream started when I was 9 years old, and my grandfather took me to the 1957 World Series in Yankee Stadium. And I remember walking into that stadium, remembering all the beautiful smells and the beautiful big stadium there. My idol Mickey Mantle was playing, the Yankees were on the field, and that's when I said that someday I'm going to play in Yankee Stadium. And I remember I did it that distinctly. And so I knew I had a lofty goal, a lofty dream that I wanted to achieve. So I knew all great dreams start with a plan. And you have to work that plan. You have to reach your goal, you have to stay disciplined, set priorities, and stay focused. And I also knew, and something every person in this room should know, nothing in this world is free. Everything comes with a price. And that price is time. You have to take your time to develop your talents and skills to reach your goals. You have to pay the price to be successful. It's not free. Everything comes with a price. And I said earlier, my dreams are over. It's your turn to dream. And I guess the question is, are you going to pay the price to reach your dreams and goals? I thank you very much for having me, and I wish you all the luck in the world. It's an exciting world out there, and just go for it.